Wisdom and Compassion Dharma Spreading University. It is our honor and pleasure to have Campbell Soda Jirinpoche and all of you gathering here again. This is the 8th live stream of Karen Boche's global teaching.
各位朋友，大家晚上好，欢迎大家来到智悲弘法大学的网络课程直播现场。非常荣幸能够再次邀请到索达吉堪布仁波切与各位齐聚一堂。今晚我们将有幸聆听仁波切的第八次全球开示。
First, imagine that in front of you are a glass of muddy water. What shall we do if we want to separate the mud and the water? Of course, we can use a water filter.Yet a more natural way, maybe just leave it on the table until the mud has been settled underneath.
首先问大家一个问题，假如在您面前放着一杯浑浊的水，您会用什么办法来将杯中的水和泥沙分离开呢？滤水器当然是一个选择，不过更直接的方法就是将杯子放在那里，让泥沙自然沉淀下来。
For most of ordinary people like us, the state of our mind is very similar to the muddy water. Yet, we barely do anything or do not know how to deal with this situation.
对于绝大多数的人来说，我们的心就如同浑浊的水，而我们几乎不管它。或者就算想管也没有头绪。
We human beings have conquered space, Mount Everest, and numerous other challenges. Yet, we may never think seriously to conquer our own mind or to remove the mud from our mind. Just to think, how often we find ourselves.Victim to our own negative thoughts or emotions, and then how we have responded to them.
我们作为人类，征服了太空，征服了珠穆朗玛峰，超越过无数的极限，可是却从来没有深思过如何征服自己的心，或者说如何过滤掉心中的淤泥。试想一下。我们是多么频繁地受害于自己的负面想法和情绪，而却对此无能为力呢？
Some people may have the opinion that it is impossible to control our thoughts. However, just as to separate the mud from a glass of muddy water, there is variety of methods, especially in the way of meditation.To make us conquer our mind, to make us control our thoughts.
也许有人会想，我们不可能完全掌控自己的思绪，但是正如水中的泥沙能被分离出来一样，实际上有很多方法能让我们征服自心，掌控思绪。禅修就是很好的一种方式。
The art of meditation teaches that.Not only is it possible to control our thoughts, but we can learn to stop them completely. Through meditation, we can bring our unruly mind under control. This creates the peace of mind and enables us to achieve what we want.
禅修的艺术不仅让掌控思绪成为可能，更让我们能够完全止息妄念。通过禅修，我们能够驾驭妄念纷飞的心，并且获得平静，达到我们希望的状态。
Meditation methods are various. And today, we have Karen Boche here to introduce us the Buddhist meditation, which generally makes up by two kinds of practices, shamatha and vipassana. What shamatha does,Basically, is to get the mud settled. Yet, what Vipassana does is to get rid of the mud.
禅修的方法多种多样，而今天索达吉堪布仁波切要向我们介绍的，则是佛教的禅修。 概括而言，佛教的禅修主要分为寂止和圣观。寂止就如同将水中的淤泥沉淀下来，而圣观则如同去除淤泥。
Thus, for those who intend to totally control their mind, both meditation of shamatha and vipassana are inevitable. And only with a controlled or tamed mind could be able to face any situation, good or bad in our daily life, could we then to build a better world.
因此，对于想要完全掌控自心的人而言，寂止和圣观的禅修必不可少。这样的禅修使我们的心变得更加调柔，然后我们就能够面对任何生活中的起起落落，世界将显得更加美好。
Now, I'd like to invite you to join me in welcoming Karen Bucci to give us tonight's teaching of Buddhist meditation, Build a Better World. Before Rinpoche starts, let's first chant some prayers.
接下来，让我们一起欢迎仁波切为我们做今晚的开示，主题是佛教禅修带来改变。在开示之前，让我们一起先进行念诵。
我们三巴拉三巴拉巴玛拉萨拉玛三巴巴嗡巴娑我们三巴三巴拉巴玛拉萨拉玛三巴巴嗡巴娑我们三巴拉三巴拉巴玛拉萨拉玛三巴巴嗡巴娑我那遮那达拉耶兰遮巴扎西修亚那亚巴耶桑吉丘达给丹巴巴娑格拉香萨达丘扎西修尊美迦婆萨达顿哲贡显巴迦瓦给泽华丹巴格拉贡巴迦吉赞巴吉伦波达波萨哲华达那三坚檀迦拉贡哲巴瓦耶僧扎巴扎热扎瓦得僧僧都扎西华贝瓦得瓦修巴迦拉香萨罗迦瓦云那瓦旦多吉赞显瑞柔仙波瓦萨依娘波哲巴南巴斯南奎娘波帕丘根德萨尔巴多吉巴格热香达诺沃达瓦热子涅玛依香子勒南扎西华吉丘香却萨瓦迦拉香萨罗仁钦德丘扎西斯杰娘顿教翁桑耶翁伽玛拉念照东道本座华为翁将座王杰阔罗德仁钦达丘迦吉僧赞杰修帝迦瓦丘穷吉杰玛格索我真贝瓦贝俄扎西拉摩迦拉香萨罗从巴钦波德久哲美俄摩东丹达迦波耶库中帕吉波达拉瓦摩摩萨南多哲德拉泽库罗达这些拉当东东多杰坚巴瓦拉哲丘等迦僧僧萨瑟内瑟给拉扎西贝揭顶迦瓦迦拉香萨罗达迦当德夏瓦尊巴拉格达涅瓦切瓦根耶涅多德万贝三德耶言者扎西德拉本僧卓巴修尊丹帝贡波迦瓦亚拉夏萨罗冈格罗卓哲尼真扎尼达南达热色维揭尼僧根基热谢尼揭德格热万僧冈达哲别僧热玛热门登达揭热我本拉我吉达子耶拉哲吉扬丹松 遮达却遮念摩念罗利揭迦遮遮萨迦玛拉玛萨达尼格吉尼遮遮热遮达多内达迦三揭他三云达利遮迦遮头格揭扎揭达揭尼揭遮达罗玛萨迦瓦扬拉德瓦热不兹那多热不兹那多热不兹那多热不兹那多热不兹那多我若不自难度若不自难度若不自难度若不自难度若不自难度若不自难度若不自难度若不自难度我若不自难度自难切切切饶人切大路的梦门巴热色内嘎当丹就用了多巴耶罗珠波比那瓦杰德苏
各位在座的佛教的还有正在听说我们现场直播的一些全球的对参修的爱好者，今天呢很开心跟大家有这么一个关于佛教参修方面的一些交流的机会，那么接下来呢，我想简单的说一下所谓的禅修，其实禅修呢，有实践的一些禅修，还有佛教的一些禅修，实践的禅修呢。主要将我们的心平静下来，不要有烦恼啊、痛苦啊、压力啊，就是这么一个状态。而初实践的这些禅修呢，它有出离心、菩提心，还有无二慧，或者说是不愿的慧相做色彻。这样的这种禅修呢是比较深奥的。今天呢我们可能着重也就是讲述一些佛教的这个禅修方面的道理。
Hi everyone, for you all present here or for the Dharma friends listen through the internet. Today we are going to talk about meditation.And I'm very happy to have this opportunity to share my thoughts about meditation. So I will briefly to introduce there are two types of meditation. That the one for ordinary beings that we practice in our daily lives that can to calm your mind, to subdue your depression, your emotional problems and suffering.And another one is the Buddhism meditation that which have more advanced level that we have to have the renounce arise the compassion mind and then when you finish your meditation to dedicate your merit in the emptiness stateSo today, I will most emphasize on the Buddhism meditation.
为什么要讲禅修呢？实际上，我们现在世界上的无论是什么样的人，东方人也好，西方人也好，或者说是有钱的人也好，没有钱的人也好，大家共同具有的有一些烦恼、痛苦，还有比较浮躁的这种心， 那么这样的信呢，其实，跟我们的家庭生活，包括就是对整个全球的人类社会，都带来了，非常可怕的一些危机和危害，甚至的话呢，让我们的整个世界各个角落的很多人呢，不快乐，就是不安心，会导致这样的结果。
So, why we choose this topic? Seeing that in the Eastern world or in the West world, all the people from different social, different aspects from the, our world that poor and rich, we all undergo some suffering in our lives, and we have this restless mind always be tortured by it. So, and if we can't to watch to control our mind, then it will bring a lot of negative influence, no matter on our personal lives, such as that you have to communicate with your family, or it will bring the negative effect in the worldwide in the worldwide range that create a lot of crisis in this world. To bring the unpeaceful and negative influence to this world, so there is it's very necessary to watch our mind and to know our mind.
佛教当中，讲我们人类社会，许多不幸福的因素呢，主要是来源于我们的自信，自己的心。当我们没有控制好自己的心，心里就产生了贪心、嗔心、痴心，以及各种烦恼的时候呢。在这个世界的各个地方会发生各种不同的包括战争包括环境危机以及呢就是许许多多的灾难和痛苦。
So from the Buddhism perspective, it said all this unhappiness on this very painful and the feelings actually all come from our mind and it bent our mind, such as all the afflictive emotions that arise your mind, the attachment, hatred and ignorance, which bring the war and the climate issues in nowadays.
因为我们的心没有安顿下来，升起各种贪嗔痴，在自己的家庭当中，或者说在自己的单位里面，或者说来自这个国家和世界当中呢，也会发生许多不快乐的事情。比如说，我们的贪心过于增长的原因呢，出现许多环境问题。现在有一些资料就显示呢，就是说我们的大自然界，不知道在座的看过没有？有一部影片呢，叫做是《大自然在说话》。意思就是说，这里面就是讲我们人类需要大自然，大自然呢不一定是需要我们的人类，但因为我们的贪心过于，开发各种各样的矿产，破坏大自然的所有的包括森林江河等等等，那这样一来的话呢，据有些资料当中显示说。我们人类到2100年的时候，实际上的1/6的这个物种呢，就会灭绝， 所以这是对我们整个全球的人类来讲，是非常大的一个危机。我们在座的各位呢，也应该值得思考。我们既要思考我们所生存的环境，更要关心到我们的人类的将来的子孙后代。那么他们如何生存？他们如何生活在这个地球上？这也是我们每一个人来讲应该值得关心和值得思考的问题。
So I say that all the afflictive emotions that will bring disaster effects on our with your when you communicate with your family members when you work in the at work or in the country. So at we have nowadays we have so much desires that it might bring damage to our environment. There is a film, I don't know if you have watched it before. It's the name of the film says The Nature Speaking. It means that the nature doesn't need human, but our human being, our existence of and the survival of our human solely depend on the nature. So because of the desire that we have that human just to explore this planet and cause a lot pollution for the river and cut down all the trees. And a report said I read recently, it said that by about 1 in 6 species will become extinct in the by the year of 2100. So this is a global crisis that we all human beings have to face. So I think that for all we here, we should not just think from our own interest, but we have to think about for our next generation, how they are going to survive, how they are going to live in this world.
我们内心没有获得自在的时候，即使得到许多的财富呢，不一定很快乐。应该前一个月吧，大概8月30号的时候呢，有一个今日英国的今日英国的一个今日邮报的，就是这么一个资料当中呢，我看到有一个人呢，他突然发财，一夜暴发，那么他是主要沙盘游戏的，有个叫做是我的世界，因为他开创这样的一种游戏呢，后来他挣的钱特别多，好像10多亿欧元，像人民币计算的话，大概是98多亿，就是这么多的钱呐，一个人拥有。当他有了这么多的钱的时候呢，按理来讲应该心情是非常快乐的，但是他面临着很多问题，他需要面对的许多事情。从此之后，他自己也说我不快乐，我对未来就是没有什么希望，甚至的话他越来越孤独。那么他这个道理映射的什么样的问题呢？我们知道。我们自己的心还没有得到控制之前，即使有非常多的钱财呢，也许对我们自身的心灵不一定带来真实的幸福。
So if we don't have a calm mind, then the money or the wealth that we have won't bring us happiness. I read the newspaper from England. It just said a guy who is the founder of a game, Minecraft. He just become rich in suddenly, and then he It, I heard that he had about 9.8 billion. So, even though he possessed so much money, that for our normal people, our ordinary people, we might think that he must be very happy since he's very rich. He got everything he wants. But that is not true. From the he himself described, he is not happy after he become rich, and he faced some other new problems in his life, and he even feel that he quite a little bit sense of isolated from other people. So it means that if we can't control our mind, how many wealth that we possess won't bring us happiness that as we think.
同样的，我们的社会当中，如果心没有获得自在，升起极大的嗔恨心呢，也对人类带来非常的不安。从小的方面讲，我们家庭的暴力，人与人之间的争斗，那么这些都是因为你的愤怒，你的这种嗔恚心而导致的。从如果大的方面讲，国家与国家之间的战争，尤其是现在看来，全球性的有些战争，对整个人类社会带来极大的恐怖。比如说像叙利亚的战争，应该说如今在我们这个世界当中，有许许多多的一些难民，就偷渡到就欧美为主的各个国家。我以前看过，光是今年2015年，在这个时候呢，有2300多万人，应该2300多人，不是万人，2300多人呢，因为在偷渡的过程当中呢，而这个丧失生命。在座的各位都看到，我们这个月的9月3号的时候呢，有个叙利亚的孩子，大概是3岁，他呢就是在土耳其的海边，因为想获得自由和获得真实的一个家庭，最后呢就是死在海边上。那么他的照片呢，在欧洲各个国家，甚至在中国也是当时网上这个疯传的特别厉害。虽然他的照片，应该说是在很多国家以前不接受难民的有些国家当中呢，改变了一些主意，但是我们都知道，现在全球来讲，难民问题是非常可怕的事情，有很多无家可归的这些人，没有国家、没有家庭、没有依靠的这些人呢，主要的来源就是战争，战争的来源呢，就是我们恐怖的嗔恨心。
So the negative of hatred in our society, such as it might cause the conflicts in the family and the conflict that between the nations. From the big view, it may cause the wars in our world. In this year, I read that 2015, about 2,300 refugees has lost their lives. And on September 3rd, I think many of you already know that a little boy, his body was found by the sea, and that her family was trying to get a better life to other countries. But they just failed. So the hatred caused many horrible things in our planet. And there are many refugees nowadays. They are trying to flee to other countries like Europe to get better lives. But they just become homeless, and they don't have food to eat and no place to live. Where this all this suffering comes from? It comes from war, and the war is because of our hatred.
关于难民的问题啊，我以前去过有些国家的时候， 我亲眼看到过很多难民生存的一些状况，当时心里很悲痛。记得去年在耶鲁大学呢，我有一次讲社会管理和禅修的话题。本来这个禅修呢跟难民没有很多的关系，但是我到了后面的时候呢，我忍不住就是讲了一些话。我的意思呢，就是说，不管是我们全球当中的什么样的人，其实，应该关心，就是现在世界当中有这么多的无家可归的这些难民，那么他们呢，毕竟是人类，我们应该就是想办法关心他们，应该想办法让他们呢早日找到就是自己的家园。所以我个人而言呢，的确也感觉就发自内心而想的话呢，觉得我们世界上有很多很多的连自己的国土都没有，连自己家的生存的没有的这些难民呢，在人类来讲呢，他是非常可怜的。
So for the refugees, for their live conditions, I have witnessed with my own eyes that last year I went to some other countries and I see how they live. I feel so many sad in my heart. And I also went to Yale University. In the Yale University, my topic is management and meditation.Actually, the refugee topic is relevant with meditation, but I just can't help to tell the audience there to ask them to care about those refugees, because no matter what, they are human beings just like us. They need our care, and we need to try our best to help them and help them to find their home and find their house and give them better life. So sincerely, that we just need to think about how miserable that lives for those refugees have, and as a human being, we should have compassionate mind for them.
还有我们的痴心啊，愚痴的心也导致了许多的不安。现在人们感觉到生活压力非常大，不管是什么身份的人都觉得自己特别忙，工作压力、生活压力、生存压力，有很多很多的压力。我最近看到一个中国的一个热线调查的报告里面，就是说对中国而言，现在96.6%的人呢都有很大的这种生活压力，其中15.5%，那么他们要接近就精神崩溃的就是这么一个状态。就非常这个可怕的，而且现在我们白领当中呢，有76%，都是处于一种亚健康，表面上看呢很不错的，但实际上，亚健康状态。那么真正就是没有压力的，或者说是非常健康的人呢，就3%左右，这是也是一个非常比较这个现实的这个调查。报告当中呢是这样讲的，所以我们在座的都可以看到，就是现在世界上的很多的人呢，因为盲目的需求一些自己的所需要的各种各样的贪婪的这种对境，正因为自己是比较盲目的原因呢，最后到不到自己的目标，心里非常痛苦，导致呢我们身心都不健康，非常困惑，带来就种种的这种苦楚。
So for the ignorance, it also can cause many suffering for us. And nowadays, people have different kinds of stress from their life, from their work, and other aspects. I just read a survey. It says that about 60% of the participants has said that they are have feel the stress from their work, and about 15% they feel they're close to collapse due to the stress they feel from their work and life, and 76% the white collars that they just their house in the although they look good but they're not physically housed. Only 3% people have the truly housed. So why have this all these numbers? I mean this survey tell us that because people blindly pursue the things that good for them, but since their goal is not realistic, so it causes so much suffering and confusion in their life, and bring them both physically and mentally suffering.
刚才我以上提到的，因为人们的贪嗔痴而引发的关于环境问题、难民问题，以及呢我们生活当中的压力等等，那这些问题，可能很多人会感觉到，确实现在我们这个世界有许许多多的这些问题，但是我们每个人就是在这样的茫茫众生当中啊，芸芸众生当中，就是非常的渺小啊，可能无力反击，只有就非常糟糕的就是延续下去，或者说是只有同流合污，可能没有办法就是继续反抗或者是反思，很多人可能有这种想法，但是我觉得呢，这种想法是不合理的，因为我们现在存在的很多问题呢，人类自己造成的，那么自己造成的许许多多的这些现实问题呢，其实人类自身呢应该有办法解决，应该呢有办法呢就是重新就是更加就是过一个非常平安的完美的就是这样的这个生活。
So the afflictive motion of our human beings, such as hatred, ignorance, and attachment, cause the war, refugee problems, and stress in our lives. And many people think, yes, so we have all these problems, but you might think that you're so small and powerless that we might can't do anything about it. All these big problems, we can't find back. Maybe just let it spread out, all the negative things and negative influence spread out in this world. This is, maybe you think like this, but I don't think so. Because all these problems, who created it? It's our human being self. So since we create these problems, then we do have the methods and ways to solve it and bring us a happy and peaceful life.
如今在全球发生的各种各样的不开心的这些事情呢，实际上如果我们真正要解决它，如果我们去真正要想办法就压服或者说是胜服它的话呢，人类自身应该有这个能力，因为一旦我们能解决心理问题的时候呢，实际上幸福呢掌握在我们自己的手里，幸福应该掌握在我们自己的手里。可能现在的很多人呢非常关心的外在的一些物质方面，包括我们许多人想开一个非常好的一些名车住一些 非常豪华的洋房啊，还有经常我们试用的这些高档的一些设备啊，等等等，就是人们呢，就是觉得是这是我们在生存当中非常重要的事。实际上，很多人没有发现，如果我们真正掌控自己的心灵，真正能认识自己的心的话呢，可能比很多外在的物质、外在的财富呢，就更加重要，而且对我们带来的快乐，给我们带来的这种充实的生活呢，更加迅速。
Many people in this age, they're only concerning about the external wealth. They care about their care put a lot energy about to pursue the brand cars, fancy house, and technology facilities. So they think that it can bring them truly happiness. But I think if we can control our mind and taming our mind, this is the top priority, surpass those external wealth.
完了。开的车。
Fancy house.
完了是吧？完了吗？可以了是吧？我觉得有点少了。没有是吧？我刚才在讲，我们一般的不管什么身份的人类都觉得需要物资方面的一些条件。当然，我们也承认，我们人生存在这个世界上呢，需要外在的物质的一些支撑，或者说是它的一些帮助。但是更重要的，要驾驭自己的心，也就是说，调服自己的心。如果能调服自己的心的话呢，可能物质解决不了的许许多多的问题呢，就是可以解决。物质满足不了的许许多多的欲望呢，也得以满足。物质呢，提供不了的许许多多的这种幸福快乐呢，就是它可以提供。所以，如果有一些禅修的人呢，无论是他身体处于什么样的环境，无论他借助什么样的人，应该过得很安全，过得很开心。
I don't deny that we need basic material stuff to survive and to live in this world. But I think the more important is to know how to tame your mind, how to control your mind. Then the material cannot satisfy us that our mind can. And from the material aspect that we come solve the problems, and if you know better about yourself, then you can solve it. And the material from the external world, from the external material that cannot give you happy, and if you know how to tame your mind, then you can be happy. So for practice experienced meditator or practitioner, no matter what kind environment he live in, and what kind of people he communicate with, he can always lead himself a very happy life.
因此我们在生活当中如果这个浮躁的心呐，浮躁的情绪能平静下来，那么一定要需要一种禅修。如果有了禅修的境界的时候呢，世间的很多的普通人呐， 他就根本解决不了，或者说是他极其可怕的一些事情呢，对他来讲非常容易的去面对。在美国这个伯克利分校还有这个加州大学的分校呢，他们最近专门就是建立了一些藏传佛教的禅修的研究。那么通过禅修，通过跳性，就是将自己的负面的这些情绪呢，就是加以调整。我们藏族有一种说话叫做是，生祸的时候呢，先注意到这个祸患，就意思就是说呢，我们人的这种情绪比较平和的时候呢，要关心就是将来会发生的一些不同的，包括一些这个沉罗啊、痰盂啊等等，就是比较比较特殊的冲动的这样的这种心。那么通过这样的这种禅修和训练之后呢，即使你在生活当中出现了极大的爆炸的声音呢，或者说是一些恐怖的消息啊，在这个时候也是你的心呢，就是坦然面对，如如不动。所以呢，这也是我们的传统的禅修跟现代科技的这种训练方法结合起来所得到的结果。
In order to calm our this restless mind, we have to practice meditation. If you have the practice the meditation, then it can help you to solve the problems that you encountered in your daily lives, and you can to have the confidence to face it. There is a research carried on by the professors in the California and Berkeley universities. They study how the Tibetan monks, how they to adjust their mind through their meditation. In Tibetan, we say that before the fire comes out, you noticed the spark. So for this research that they investigated is they find these Tibetan monks, they can, through their meditation, even though they heard the sound as loud as the bomb, but it won't disturb us. So if we can to apply the meditation in our daily lives, even we hear the horrible news, then we won't be get disturbed or get distracted by this news. So this is a combine of the development. The result come from the technology study and the Tibetan Buddhism, their traditional meditation or practice.
Tibet Buddhism meditation. 怎么讲啊？我们这禅修啊，禅修呢，的确很重要。如果通过禅修，可以说原来是一个非常这个性格不好，就或者说他都有一些现在就所谓的一些抑郁症啊，或者说是自闭症啊等等，就是各种不良的这些病的话呢，通过禅修呢，就是可以化解。原来是我们这个心理欲望特别大，这种很难想象的人呢，通过长期的禅修的话呢，他最后这个心理呢也会获得净化，就最终呢就是心态就是非常平静。所以所谓的禅修呢，它不一定是非要有一个宗教的这个仪式和宗教的意义， 如果按照自身的一种调整方法来修的话呢，也同样起到就是它的作用。
Meditation can have a lot good influence. Meditation can bring us a lot benefits, such as if you have a bad personality, then through meditation you might be a good guy. And also for those people they suffer from depression and other mental disease, that also through meditation it can help them to adjust their mind. And if you have a lot of desire and attachment towards something or some people, then the meditation can purify your mind, bring you a stillness state. But the meditation will not mean that we can only practice when you have some religious belief. As an ordinary being in our daily lives, we can always practice meditation to benefit ourselves.
那禅修的方法呢，当然是非常多的。如果按照藏传佛教的一些禅修呢，主要有寂智和身观，就是两个方面。这种方法呢，在人和社会在人和的这种经论当中呢，都会强调的。
There are different methods to practice meditation. In Buddhism, we have the Vipassana and Shamatha. It also be put a lot emphasis in different scriptures of Buddhism.
禅修的时候，我以前也讲过，我们的这个坐式非常重要。这种坐式呢，叫这个毗卢伽梵坐式啊。在座的各位应该会懂的，主要是我们双足架趺坐，双手蹬印，然后脊椎呢就端直，还有这个颈部就是往上就向前倾，鼻尖呢就是直视前面的虚空，还有我们的这个舌尖呢就是顶上这个上颚。还有双肩呢，就是双肩呢，就是放松，就是往外展开，外面呢就是唱的歌很好听，这就是说，这个毗卢伽梵坐式啊，刚才有一个孩子在哭，就是说这种哭声跟歌声呢，就是我的参修的境界当中，把它看作是一种歌声。就讲到我刚才讲的毗卢伽梵坐式，我们在座的各位，不管你有信仰没有信仰呢，就是最好以这种坐式的话，你的禅修呢就是会成。
So when we talk about meditation, then first I want to introduce the posture that is the 7-point Vajrasana posture. So for your legs, you should sit crossed legs.And keep your spine straight. Then your chin slightly chin, and let your eyes to look at the tip of your nose slightly. Your tongue tap your up palate, and your shoulders open and back. If you can, it's better for you try to do these 7 points, because no matter your have a religious or not, if you can apply this posture when you meditate, then it can help you to better act effective on your meditation.
禅修的内容呢，主要有心安静下来，就像我们昏着的睡。让它逐渐平静下来的时候，所有的这些浑浊部分呢，就是沉淀下去。那么这叫做是一种禅定。 但是这样的禅定呢，它也有一些实践的部分，比如说我们心什么念头都没有，但没有念头呢，就是不一定是最高的一种境界。我们修行当中有命乐无念的一些觉数，但这些觉数呢，实际上是不究竟的。一旦遇到一些因缘的时候呢，它的这种念头，包括贪嗔痴呢，就是可以再次的会浮现。所以呢，我们经常说所谓的心光是安住下来，心安静下来呢，就这是暂时解决痛苦，但从根本上呢，就是还没有解决痛苦。
So meditation is to calm your mind, like the water. You put it there, then the particles of the sediment or the muddy just come down slowly. So for many people, their practice is belong to our ordinary people. It's not the highest state that we should achieve for. Although you might feel such feeling when you meditation, such as luminosity, bliss, and thought free, but it's not can lead you to liberation because all your these afflictive emotions such as hatred, anxiety, attachment, and ignorance, the seed of this emotion of these afflictive emotions are still there. So when you have encountered some things in your life, you might all your negative or your this destructive emotion might arise. Therefore, that to calm your mind, to abide your mind in a peaceful state can bring you temporarily happy, but it's not the ultimate goal that we're pursue, we're to desire.
你翻译完了给我看一下，就这样，好吧？对，这样的，先就将刚才讲到的，这叫做寂止，就是心就一种无缘的状态，就没有任何执着呢，这也是一种禅修。还有按照我们藏传佛教和汉传佛教当中呢，有一种叫做是油相的寂止。那么所谓的油相寂止呢，比如说我们观这个佛像啊，就观佛像呢，汉传佛教的观佛三昧海，就是一部经典当中专门就是从佛陀的所有的相号啊，就是相32相84岁号呢，都一个一个的观相。那么到最后的时候呢，佛陀的站着的这种形象呢也会观相，佛陀坐着的这种形象呢也会观相，这也是观佛的一种这个相。我们藏传佛教当中呢，就是对释迦牟尼佛的观修方法呢，也经常就是在自己的前面观像一个金光闪闪的，就是非常庄严的，就像我今天跟大家看的，就是这么一个释迦牟尼佛的像啊，就是这个像呢，就是应该是非常的这个庄严。我们在禅修的时候呢，就经常就是先刚开始的时候，眼睛就是盯着这个佛陀，然后呢，就自己心里面观想，到一定的时候，前面没有这个佛像啊，唐卡也好，或者说是这样的佛像，即使你没有放在前面，你自己的心呢，就是一定会是能关注。有时候呢，也可以佛陀的身体就发出光，融入自己的身体，自己的这些烦恼、负面的情绪呢，就是都得以消除啊。就是这样的这种观想方法呢，无论是藏传佛教、汉传佛教呢，都可以叫做是一种寂止，而且它的功德呢，非常大。 但是我今天呢，因为时间关系，就是不在这里叙述。当然这个呢，佛教徒就是你可以观想，即使非佛教徒，那么如果我们观这样的这种佛像的话，对你的生活呢带来一种契机，带来一种快乐，它根本不会因为你是佛教徒呢，对你有一种排斥啊，或者不加持啊，就是不会有这种现象。所以，我的建议呢，就是很多人，像愿意控制自己的烦恼，压服自己的这种痛苦的这些人呢，你经常就是看着这样的这种佛像的话呢，对你一定会是有非常多的意义和快乐。
So, in above, I have introduced the meditation without form, and there are also a meditation with form in Tibetan Buddhism, to let you to visualize the Buddha. How to visualize the Buddha? The sutra from the in the sutra it has mentioned.Let us to visualize the 32 major marks and 8 minor marks of the Buddha Shakyamuni. And after you practice, then you're able to visualize that Buddha, no matter when he's sitting or standing or lying, you can visualize vividly in your mind. You all can see the Buddha that I put next to me. When you to do this meditation, you just look at the Buddha Shakyamuni, that he has this golden color skin and very gracious, beautiful. For your the beginner practitioner, you can look at this Buddha Shakyamuni statue. After you reach a certain level, then you can.Close your eyes, but the image of the Buddha can still appear in your mind. And you can also to visualize the Buddha irradiate all different kinds of light, and this light can immerse you, and can eradicate and can the Buddha can relieve all the sadness and depression and that you feel.This kind of method to visualize Buddha Shakyamuni has mentioned in Tibetan and Han tradition. By visualizing the statue, then you can accumulate a lot of merit. Due to today the time limit, so I won't to elaborate it.But for you, no matter you're Buddhist or you're non-Buddhist, it's totally fine for you to visualize the Buddha Shakyamuni, because Buddha won't, because you're not Buddhism, that he won't give you a blessing. So for anyone who wants to control his mind, who wants to pacify his negative emotions, then to visualize the Buddha Shakyamuni and to do such meditation,can bring a lot benefit and meaningful for you.
我曾经也是在法王面前当过很多年的翻译啊，这个翻译也有很多的怎么讲，就是有时候困难。我有时候也，就别人说我翻译的不好，有些时候说我翻译的好啊，听到翻译好的时候呢，我高兴；听到我翻译不好的时候呢，很不开心。我到新加坡的时候，他们说翻译的很不错，然后又一直到台湾的时候呢，有些时候说我翻译的不好，所以我以前的生活当中的话呢，就是翻译呢。也是挑战性比较强的吧，就 不管怎么样呢，我还是以前一直很努力的，做过，所以我们以后在这个韩语、藏语、英语，还有不同民族和不同国家的这种，这个语言呢，在翻译过程当中呢，就是大家，一定要有一种学习的这种机会吧。就我们可能像我的话，我本来想是用这个各种各样的众生的语言来讲经说法，但是现在呢也正在发愿。我刚才就是讲的什么？就是机智啊，就是机智呢，说有相的机智呢，就是观佛；无相的机智呢，我们的心就是安住于一种非常平静的状态当中，没有任何执着的状态当中。那么这就是现在就是社会上各种学校也是提倡的，就是所谓的禅修。但是这种禅修呢，从究竟来看呢，就是也并不是很完美的，因为一旦因缘具足，外缘这个出现的时候，它还会产生各种烦恼。在这个时候，我们要动到这个禅修的这个性呢，它的本来的面目，也就是说，它是有这个眼耳鼻舌身等等，就是这样的无根是吗？还是他意识自己就是拥有的一种本体存在，或者说是我们的这样的这种心识呢，在外在的这个山河大地上，或者说是自己的身体的降邦啊，就是身体的上下的一个部位上，通过这样来详详细细的去观察，最后观察的时候呢，其实我们的意识也好，外在的这种事物也好，全部都到最后呢，就是空空无我的状态。那么空空无我呢，实际上是真正的万法的本来实相。一旦我们通到了这样的境界的时候呢，这叫做所谓的圣观。那么这种智慧呢，就是它彻底就是断除我们的贪嗔痴的这些烦恼，贪嗔痴的这些烦恼，就像是我们浑浊的这个。这种髓的污染呢，就是全部去完了以后，那这个髓呢，就是始终都是清澈的，是干净的、清净的。同样的道理，让我们心里的这种各种污染，就是通过无我的智慧来去除的话呢，这就是最究竟的禅定，也就是说，机智和身观双运，或者说是这个明空无二啊，就是明实智的身观，就是空呢。就是寂智，就是这样的一种境界，这是我们佛教当中才提出的，其他的宗教或其他的一些实践禅修当中不一定找到。
Can Rinpoche just to say that he also has been translator for Dharma King Jigme Pongtso for many years. Some people say that he did a very good job, then Khyam Rinpoche will be happy, and some people say that he just is not very good, then he just feel not happy. Once Rinpoche went to Taiwan, and the people there said he did such a bad job, then they might have meant, Rinpoche just remembered it. So to do a translator is a very challenge task. However, Rinpoche still strive to learn different language. Although he still don't know other than Chinese, but he still make his aspiration that he ha can master many other languages. So I think that no matter to use the Chinese or Tibetan or English, different language, when we're hearing, we should keep a studying attitude. And also back to the meditation. As I said that for the meditation, Shamatha has the meditation with form and without form. And But these have to be combined with vipassana. Otherwise, when different cause and condition, or you have an, or something that you encountered in your lives, then you might feel very peaceful and calm when you are mentored. But when you encountered those such a thing, then all your afflictive emotion just arise. Because we don't have the wisdom of vipassana, which means emptiness. And for our mind, we have the five sense consciousness and mind consciousness. If we try to observe it more closely and examine the consciousness, then we can't find it either inside our body or outside the body in the external world. So I think that everything, all phenomena is emptiness, and there's you can't find the self exist. And the essence of everything is suffering. So this is the reality of phenomena, and this is the wisdom of vipassana. And through such wisdom, that we can truly eradicate the root or the seed of our conflicted emotions or our conceptual thoughts. Just like the muddy in the water, if we clean the muddy, then the water will be clean. Likewise, we use the wisdom of emptiness can remove, can let us to go beyond this cyclic existence. So this is the ultimate meditation, which is the union of luminosity or clarity and emptiness, which is also means the combined nation of vipassana and shamatha. So this is different from the meditation that we usually know in our daily lives, that cannot lead us to enlightenment or liberation.
我们禅修过程当中呢，一定要对禅修法门有这种兴趣，有欢喜心。有了这样的欢喜心呢，自己在实际的修行当中，会投入，会去参与。我们在座的各位啊，都会有多多少少的一些烦恼啊、情绪啊、痛苦啊，那这些呢，的确，依靠禅定，让接下你的这种烦恼。我不是特意发的，但是我今天早上记得呢，就是也发过一个微博，我的这个微博里面是怎么讲的呢？我说这个无有草木的荒地呢，就是通过开垦之后，它可以变成生机勃勃的田野。然后非常浮躁还有沮丧的这个情绪呢，通过禅修之后呢，它也可以变成一种安详跳入的这个心境。所以我自己认为呢，我们不管是什么身份的人呢，可能情绪啊，就非常可怕。有时候看到人本身很好的，但自己的这种愤怒，恐怖，或者是说你的这种嗔恨心上来的时候呢，就谁也无法阻挡，自己也不相信自己。所以这就是需要一种长期的这个修学呢，才可以对治，才可以根除。
So for meditation that we have to be interested in the meditation practice and have a joyful mind for the meditation, then you will be willing to practice. For all you, we as human beings, we all have the different levels of maybe depression or other kinds unfavorable emotions. Through meditation, it can bring us a better and tranquil mental state. Just this morning, I have posted a Weibo. It said that a wasteland can turn to fertility through plows. Similarly, our depression and the anxiety and other emotions can transform into tenders and a calm mind. No matter otherwise, if we can't control our mind, then maybe this destructive emotion can bring a lot of negative effects. Maybe you think you're a good person in your daily lives, but when your hatred and anger just arise, you can't control it. You're have very maybe lose your temper, and after this, you might can't believe it that you just did such a thing.
如果我们去修行呢，应该每个人都会得到一定的收获。我以前看过有一个叫做威斯康星大学，美国的，那么。他们的有些科学家呢，就专门做过这样的一个调查和培训，五六岁的幼儿园的孩子，他们在经过八个星期当中就也就是说接近两个月吧，那么当中的话，每天呢，就是做一两次，就是三次禅修，每一次呢，大概20分钟。那他们禅修培训的内容呢，主要是感恩啊、关爱啊、合作啊等等，就是这些话题。那么刚开始这些孩子还没有正式培训之前的话，有一些帖子呢，就让这些孩子分给住遍的这些孩子的时候，他会把这些帖子自己关心好的朋友呢，就是给他们，而不会呢。就是对其他的一些不熟悉的人，或者说是对关系不好的孩子，那么他们通过这么就八个星期吧，就是两个月的这种培训下来以后呢，那最后这些孩子们的心呢，就是已经跳入通过禅修，完全就是他得到一些平和。后来这些帖子让他们分的时候呢，他一视同仁的。就根本不会就因为关心好而分给他们的，所以这是非常简单的事情。这是幼儿园的孩子，但幼儿园的孩子也是从小，如果在短短的时间当中去培训训练禅修的话呢，到最后心就是会得到跳入。我想我们今天在座的各位呢，都是大人。五六岁的孩子呢，恐怕是没有的。刚才有一个就是哭了就走了，那么其他的人呢，都要关心，就是说我们大人的话呢，就是确实经过一个月、两个月、三个月这样去培训的话，短短的时间当中，通过你的修炼呢，一定会是转变你原来的这个心态。
I know they are also experiment that carried on in the Wisconsin universities. These professors just they're preschool students that led them to meditate for 8 weeks. And this student, this child, they're just 5 or 6 age. And they do meditation about 3 times a week, and each time 20 minutes. And they contemplate on the gratitude, cooperate, kindness, and mindfulness. And before this, before they to do this training, that the researchers just to let these children to give their posters to different their classmates, and then this child just to give these posters to their friends, and don't give their that maybe they don't like the friends that people that don't like, they won't give it this poster to others. And after this 8 weeks training, then these preschool children have changed their mind. They become much more compassionate and soft, and then they would like and willing to give this poster equally to their friends and the people that they don't like. So, I mean, they're preschool child, and if they can do this, of course, we adults also can do this. Just maybe they're a little boy, just cry and leave. So if we can practice in 2 or 3 months, in this short time, we can transfer our mind into a better state.
我们这次呢也是因缘比较殊胜啊，像我们佛学院呢，每年都有大概2个礼拜的闭关的一种这个禅修，可能是在下个月，而我们在这边就韩学院这边的话呢，也提倡从昨天9月10号开始呢，就参加一种拜日的这种禅修的这个活动啊，我最近收到的消息呢，好几千人，就是包括学院内部的、学院外面的。那这个期间呢，有上等的修行者呢，就1天4座的禅修，中等的呢，1天2座，即使下等的话呢，每天的在观佛像啊，就念咒语，就10000遍以上啊，等等。大多数的修大圆满信息修习啊，还有观修本师释迦牟尼佛啊，当当诸如此类的这样的这种修行。我今天在这里呢，也是就恭敬的合掌啊，就呼吁大家呢，你们有时间呢，也尽量的参与。从我们佛教的功德角度讲呢，如果你从昨天开始，算到12月18号之间呢，每天都是，哪怕是每天念一遍，一些原文啊，就是像《普贤行愿品》啊，或者说是一些每天都是念一些原文的话呢，过了100天的时候，你的功德呢，就是有100种不同的法，就是禅修也是这样的。即使你一天只能做1座的话呢，过了100天以后，我相信你的心态呢，就是也会有百倍的这种转变。
So today it's very auspicious that about to in our Buddhist academy that we always hold about 2 months retreat in winter, and yesterday is September 10th in all the monks and nuns and lay practitioners here, they are to do the 100 days retreat. And I heard that there are about 1,000 people made part in this retreat. They have different levels. For the up levels, they can choose 4 sessions 1 day, and for the middle, they can choose 2 sessions and all they can either choose 1 session or recite mantra of the Buddha and the Bodhisattvas. Here I wish that to take this opportunity and this chance to take to also do meditation and join us retreat. Even though it's only 100 days, but if you can practice to sit one session, one day per day, then after 100 days, that your mind will have a great change.
最后呢，我在这里想讲一下，我们在座的各位，如果按照佛教的这种禅修方法的话，实际上能解决我们自己的人生问题、家庭问题，乃至这个社会和国际问题，通过禅修心里得到安静的时候呢，那么以贪婪而造成的各种环保和这个社会的一些大的这种这个灾难也可以解决。那么以嗔恨导致的战争和就包括就是难民问题等等，就是这些也可以解决的。那么以嗔心导致的我们实践当中的各种压力和痛苦呢，也可以解决。所以呢，我想每一个人如果在这个实践当中过得很快乐啊，过得自在的话呢，一定要长期的包括早上起来的时候，五分到十分钟之间的禅修，白天休息的时候、工作的时候，甚至坐车、开车，以及跟朋友聊天的时候呢，经常观自己的心，那么掌握自己的心态。那这样的话呢，最后虽然我们处在非常肮脏和复杂的这样的世界当中，但是就像拈花与你不染一样，我们每个人呢，就过的生活呢，就是更加有意义的。更重要的呢，有禅修境界的人呢，家人之间不会吵架，朋友之间呢也不会争斗。我也希望，我们通过今天的这种就是听讲吧，就是听到我的这种开始之后呢，至少也是你在100天之内呢，能不能控制自己的情绪，跟家人朋友呢，以前爱吵架的人呢尽量减少，以前不爱吵架的人呢尽量不吵架，不发生冲突和不发生暴力的这种互相的一些冲击所以这样以后呢，我们的生活呢就是过得非常美满，那么对整个世界来讲呢，会营造就是更美好的一个家园。谢谢大家，尤其是你们今天星期六的时候抽出一些最宝贵的时间来这个听书就佛教禅修的话呢，我觉得也非常希望呢，你们每一个人生活当中得来就切实的利益。乖正气。
So, I wish all of you after listen my lecture, to, at least, that, oh yeah, here. So, in the end, that I would like to say, if we can practice the meditation, and then no matter what the conflicts happened between people to people, or nation to nation, it can be solved. And through the meditation, we achieved the common mind, and all the, as I said, the pressure from work, the refugee crisis, and the environmental problems can be dispelled because our hatred and ignorance and attachment just decreased. So for you, you can apply the meditation in your daily lives. When you wake up in the morning, you can practice meditation. All your daily activities, when you're driving a car, when you're talking to a friend, then if each of you can and practice like this, then you can have a happy life. So although we live in this degeneration time or this noisy world, we can let us be like a lotus to clean from all this muddy. Through the meditation, then we can control our mind. We don't have to always quarrel with our family members or to fight with our friends. So for you all listening the lecture today, as I said, I wish you at least in 100 days that you can try to control your temper, try to control your anger and your other negative emotions. To use your verbally or body violence to other people. I really appreciate that all of you to take your time on this Saturday night to listen to this lecture, and I wish some of my words can benefit you. Thank you.
Thanks very much for Rinpoche's peace instruction on Buddhist meditation.
非常感谢仁波切有关佛教禅修的窍诀性开示。
From the Buddhist perspective, anyone can achieve a certain stage of calmness and awareness through the practice of shamatha and vipassana.The only thing that needs to be bear in mind is to persist your practice.
佛教认为任何人通过寂止和圣观的禅修都能够获得一定程度的宁静和觉知，而唯一需要我们铭记于心的就是持之以恒。
Once, Buddha was asked, "What have you gained from meditation?" He replied, "Nothing."However, Buddha said, "Let me tell you what I've lost. Anger, anxiety, depression, insecurity, fear of old, age, and death."
曾经有人问佛陀，您通过禅修收获了什么？佛陀说，什么也没有。但是佛陀接着说，我放下了愤怒、焦虑、沮丧。以及对生老病死的恐惧。
Thank you all for listening. Let's dedicate the merit to all beings by chanting the prayers.
最后，感谢各位的聆听，让我们将所有的功德以愿海精髓应持，回向一切众生。
张一左若换句真八个眼拉这几三八藏阳松多几眼大个那左不特特瓦拉一蓝秋空色色得三界七界那我从刚给自己特界念我从多你多把夜烟酒我写拉美相卷秋的多几的大家看念这个马东娃让顿一泪花了摩前吧眼巴蓝波三兄皆阴顶今儿吧笑这不中切了千万跟大压几千把的千万万无几阴几色中跟大三波摩蓝里淡波想求修把加速他心胸莫难这个价格接着用的晚餐加入菜的门菜大大压着你内修的切拉青春里被我特多笑算理解这我曾见那菜的不菜的亲养的亲我曾懂把送给龙丹托亲自你不再亲这把笑这美家当当要引得你瑞美中能盆地花几错你跟夜拉门把的姑娘 顿切松格央当德庄扎西冈耶本座德耶德玛利杰给念索索索门摩西格巴萨江摩涅波给拉那维萨森恰巴修阿红班泽格热班马泽德红阿红班泽格热班马泽德红阿红班泽格热班马泽德红